The sights and sounds of India are very interesting and colourful, and as we go along the highway, we try and give you a taste of that diversity. Travelling to Rajagiri or Rajagat, which is one of the most ancient cities in the world. It is the capital of the kingdom of the powerful King Bimbisari, who ruled northern India during the Buddha's time. Buddha visited this area many times and had a number of rain retreats there. During our journey, we were stopped at a number of places by a gang of young men who set up roadblocks like this one. They demanded 10 rupees from our driver before we were let through. Was built in the late 1970s to take pilgrims to the Vishwashanti Stupa, which was also built by the Japanese in the name of world peace. This stupa is 125 meters tall and its dome is 144 meters in diameter. Is one of the most sacred places in the life story of the Buddha. 16 years after enlightenment, the Buddha assembled 5,000 followers and continued teaching the Dharma to them for 12 years. Many of the sutras, which contain the essence of the Buddhist teachings, originated from here. This Grihagutta hill is one of the most important places associated with Gautama Buddha's life. At this place, 16 years after his enlightenment, the Buddha set forth the second turning of the wheel, when he preached to 5,000 monks, nuns and laity. He continued teaching here for 12 years, and some of the most important teachings of Buddhism, such as the Prajnaparamita Sutra and the Sarangama Samadhi Sutra, were given here. Walking down the hill on a road which was originally built by King Bimbisara so that he could come and listen to the Buddha's sermons. is Rajgir town, which we are passing on our way to Nalanda. In India, the Hindus treat the cow as a very sacred animal. So, when they step onto the road, they have the right of way. Site of the great Buddhist University of Nalanda, which was originally built around the 5th and 6th century. Both a monastery and a place of learning, Nalanda is believed to be amongst the first universities in the world. At the peak of its glory between the 6th and 12th century, Nalanda is believed to have 9 million books, 10,000 students and 2,000 teachers. Before the university was established, Buddha had visited here many times and had even taught the Dharma to King Bimbisara here.
That chant, if you adopt Lord Buddha and before Buddha, it was in form of well-developed area, cultivated area, and people there were very prosperous and very knowledgeable. There were so many ponds which were full of lotus, and that's why due to abundance of lotus, it became Nalanda. So it was the place of lotus.
Nalanda was one of the pioneers of university education in the world. And this monastic university was established in the 5th or the 6th century. It produced many of the famous scholars of this era until the Muslim invaders chased out the monks and burnt down this place in the 12th century. Well, these are what remains of the lecture halls, the monasteries, and the libraries. One of the lecture halls with a cooling water system underground. These are the ruins of the main temple in Nalanda. Even today, Buddhists pay homage here as this group of Burmese pilgrims are doing. Sights and sounds of India, we need to take something home to remember it.
Namaskar, good morning everybody. Today we are going to a long way. We have to go to a long way. We will stay tonight in Kushinara. Now it is called Kushinagar. Near about 425 kilometers from Rajgir. And on the way we will visit Vaishali also. Somewhere road is broken. I told you that we are in Bihar and especially the road condition is very bad here.
This time of year, that is early January, in northern India, it is very cold and foggy. To take us to a destination before nightfall, the driver had to keep on driving even though the visibility was disappearing. It really needs some good skills and a good eyesight. Restrooms or toilets in India is not easy when you are on the road. This is one of those stops. To stop, relax and relieve. Thank you. We're now at the Asoka Pillar in the town of Vaishali, where democracy was born. The world's first republic flourished here in the 6th century. Gautama Buddha had visited this area many times. On one visit, a monkey came and offered him a bowl of honey. This was considered a great event in the life of the Buddha. This is one of the famous Asoka pillars, which Emperor Asoka built around India more than 2,500 years ago to mark the important places associated with the life of the Buddha. In Vaishali, where Buddha accepted females into the monastery and an order of nuns was established. It is also here that the Buddha announced his approaching death, and after his death, the Buddha's relics were distributed to 8 places. These are the remains of a stupa built to protect one of those relics.
මේ ස්ථානය තමයි බුදුරජාණන් වහන්සේ අවසානට ධර්ම දේශනා කරේ භික්ෂුන් වහන්සේලා ඇතුළු බෞද්ධ අබෞද්ධ සියලුම ජනතාවට මේ ස්ථානයේ ඉඳලා තමයි ධර්මය දේශනා කරේ.
We are here in Kushinara, where Gautama Buddha passed away or attained Parinirvana. He died in this city at the age of 80 on the 6th lunar month, Vesak Full Moon Day, 45 years after attaining enlightenment in Buddha Gaya. Today, this is a popular destination for Buddhist pilgrims from across the world. The place where the body of the Buddha was cremated. This stupa was built by Emperor Asoka to commemorate this event. Though Buddhism is no more a major religion in India, millions of Buddhists from around the world visit these places associated with the life of the Buddha every year. Plus, Buddhist organizations from overseas have built many Buddhist shrines and monasteries across India to cater for these pilgrims. This is the Sri Lankan Japanese Buddhist monastery in Kushinaga. Monastery every Monday, Venerable Asaji conducts healing sessions for the local people, most of whom are not even Buddhists. He argues if you do it with a genuine love for the people, the power of healing is very much present in this place. This impressive temple has been built by the Thais. They too provide medical services to the local community as well as educational facilities. Local children are here assembling for the Sunday school on this chilly winter morning. We're now leaving Kushinara and soon we'll be at the India-Nepali border to visit Lumbini, the birthplace of Prince Siddhartha.